Today, I will show you how to re-sterilize contaminated tissue culture plants. How's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So yes, unfortunately, my Philodendron, Pedatum, Variegated got contaminated. It got contaminated a couple of days ago, and the contamination is quite severe. It's advancing pretty quick. So let me give you a closer look of what I'm talking about. So this is the plant right here. You can see all the contamination. It has got contaminated super fast. It's been only been a couple of days, and this looks like Shay's mushrooms by now. So you haven't seen any of the Shay's videos here at the Plant Cell Technology channel. Make sure to check them out every Sunday. So he makes work with some mushrooms. Unfortunately, I don't want any of this. I don't want any of this like a fungus contamination. So today I want to re-sterilize it. So let me show you how I do that. All right, so I want to do something different. I have tried this in the past and it worked for me. So I want to be using the microscope. Normally when you want to re-sterilize a plant, you want to take it up, place it back in bleach and for like maybe, I don't know, 50 minutes and then put it, rinse it with water and place it back in a tissue culture cup. Whatever, I want to do something different. Something I have tried in the past and worked, which is the meristem culture. So I want to use the microscope, I want to take the plant out, and I want to open the leaves, take the meristem culture and place it in my new media. So I still have to kind of clean the plant, but it's going to be a less of a cleanup. So let me show you what I'm going to do. So let me take the plant out. So let me give you a better close up. So now I'm taking, look how contaminated this is. Super fast, very aggressive fungal contamination. So I just want to take my plant out, place it here on my petri dish. Anyways, you can see all the fungal contamination like right here. So I just need to get rid of all of this. And I'm going to be using 70% isopropyl alcohol. So I just want to spray the plant. This is all I'm going to use. Use alcohol. That's it. So let's go back to the frame. So I'm just going to give it a, I'm going to give it a clean up. Now, what did it go contaminated? Oh, you can, well, you saw that the contamination was very aggressive. So in my opinion, well, there are a couple things. So one, it could be that the water that I use, I did mention that that was the same water I used for my cactus tissue culture. So it was already open. So when you open an open gallon of water, of the still water, it's a sterile. Whatever that was, I was already used, so I already opened it. It was open in the fruit, so I thought it was going to still be sterile. It may have not been the case. It may have been already not be a sterile anymore, sterile water anymore. So that could have been why it got contaminated. The other reason why it may have got contaminated, it might be because the bleach that that I had is very old. So I need to get rid of that bleach and just get a new one. But yeah, bleach kind of over time, it kind of lost its strength. So I think that was probably a part of the reason. It was probably not as strong, because I mean, I was actually quite surprised how healthy you can see the plant looks like with 20 minutes of 10% bleach. I think new bleach would have done a lot more damage, a lot quicker. So that was probably, my bleach was probably not as effective anymore. So, all right, so that's probably going to be it for this. I'm going to review now.
even another spray with alcohol. I just want to place it on this sterile paper towel, which is also has it has also been soaked with a 70% isopropyl alcohol. I want to clean this up. A little bit more alcohol, and I'm going to flame it. Because now I have a sterile plate. And I want to take my plant and let's open this up. You can see now the oxidation that the bleach did. That's okay, that's on the outside. Make sure it's a frame. What I want to do is to open this base, so you can see right here. There we go. This is what I want to do. I want to take it easy with this plant. I want to be careful not to damage it that much. There we go, look at that. So as I remove these pieces of leaf, I want to be careful not to touch the inside, like with the outside that I have just removed. So I can see, you saw I removed this layer of leaf, that layer. So I want to place my scalpels back in the sterilizer for like 10-15 seconds, so I got they're re-sterile again. So I make sure the inside, so I make sure that I don't contaminate the inside of the plant, because the outside has been contaminated. It was exposed to the fungus, and the inside is still sterile. So if I can take that layer, those leaves, take it out as careful as possible, not to touch the inside, take it out, discard it, re-sterilize my tools, and then the inside is still sterile, so I can still work. So I have to do a couple layers, re-sterilize a couple layers, all the way until I get to the very end. Right, so now I'm going to open this up a little bit more. So now I grab my scalpel. Very carefully, this the blade very sharp. You have to let the blade do all the job for you. I have cut this in two pieces, so this is going to be my first piece. There is an apical meristem inside there. There may be another one inside here, but I'm not going to take it, so I want to discard that. Same as this. And there is another apical meristem here. So take all this out. And I don't need to go all the way to the apical meristem. I just need to get it to the inside layer, so I know the inside is still sterile. So I think pretty much I'm almost ready to make my kind of my final cuts. So I just want to cut this up first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to one more time sterilize my tools. All right, so you can see the inside right here. So I have to be very careful here, because the apical meristem is just right here, so or they should be. So I just want to clean this up a little bit more. So basically this is a shoe tip. It's larger than a shoe, that what I would consider a shoe tip. But this is basically what I'm taking. But actually, you know what? Feels like I want to go a little bit. I want to remove this other layer, I think. At this point, probably better to use a two scalpels. Oh yeah, there we go. This is exactly what I need. Right here. This is perfect, right here. You can clean this up a little bit more, that's great. So this is a shoot tip of this philodendron. So the shoot tip still has like the apical meristem with a couple of final leaf primordials. And this is what I'm going to take place in my cup. So it is very small. Maybe it still be an apical meristem inside this right here, this tissue. So I want to place it into a new cup of media. There we go. So there we go, you can see it now a little bit better. So now I have two. So this one has one right here. So this is the part of the note, the very bottom of the note. And this have two apical meristems. One came up very clean. The one on this side came up pretty clean. It's hard to see. It's right there. This other one didn't come up very clean at all. Actually, I'm not sure if I even have the meristem there, but I'm going to place it. I just place it in the media anyways. Hopefully, it doesn't get contaminated again, and hopefully it grows, because taking the part of the shoe tip is going to take a lot longer than just taking like a bigger cut. It's definitely going to take... it's definitely going to take more time to get plants from this. They are very, very small, so they're going to definitely take some time to grow from here. So anyways, I hope you have enjoyed it. Now, you want me to see more in depth of how to use a microscope, and some other techniques of tissue culture. Make sure to check the tissue culture masterclass. We're going to have an online version coming soon, and we are very excited. So make sure to check the link down in the description where you can sign up for the class. Hope you have enjoyed it, and I will see you on the next one.